Good afternoon. Welcome to our event on health systems. My name is Pınar Keskin Ocak. I'm the director of the Center for Health and Humanitarian Systems here at Georgia Tech and also a faculty member in the School of Industrial and Systems Engineering. I know that several of you came here from other parts of Atlanta. Some of you came here from out of town. So a big welcome to all of you, whether you are from Georgia Tech or other organizations visiting us today, especially on this rainy weather day. So we really appreciate you all being here. So we have a fantastic program ahead of us with wonderful speakers. We will start with a rapid fire session and then continue into our panel. But I would like to say a couple of words before we begin. And then, of course, we have our posters outside, which I hope all of you are going to visit during the break. So, as I mentioned, I'm the director for the Center for Health and Humanitarian Systems. The center has been around for about 11 years, and we do a lot of work both in the health systems area and also humanitarian systems. Our activities focus on education, outreach, and collaborative projects and research with our partners. Some of our partners are here in Georgia, others are in other parts of the country, and then we also have partners in other parts of the world. So it's been a fantastic journey being part of this center from its early days up until today. And I also want to acknowledge a lot of people on campus and outside, our friends who made this possible by working with us over the years. And some of them are in this room. So please visit our center to find out the website to find out more about our activities. So I also would like to acknowledge our organizers who have worked tirelessly to put together the program for this year. So I'm gonna go and if they are here, if they could please stand and be recognized. Beth Minet, I guess she's not here today with us. Mike Best. Is Mike around? Okay. Shatakshi, I know she is out of town. Sherry Farugia is right here. Thank you, Sherry. And Bill Todd, right here. So let's give them a big hand. And as you all know, if you've been involved in the organization of such an event, it takes a village to put it together. So many, many people across campus worked tirelessly to put together all the logistics and other details of this event. So let's give them a big hand as well for all their hard work. And then, of course, I would like to thank our speakers, rapid-fire speakers, moderator, panelists, and all of you, our participants, for being with us today. Thank you. So health systems, we are going to talk about the next generation. So I thought it would be fun to look back and see how things were some years ago. And it was a bit scary for me to look at some of these pictures. So I'm glad that we made some progress in terms of how we practice healthcare and health systems today and the kinds of technology that we use. So this is kind of our, thankfully, we are here today and not, you know, 100 years before moment. But despite all our progress, health still remains to be one of the biggest challenges that we face, both in the United States and around the world. So it's if you look at the United Nations Millennium Development Goals, you'll see that several of them are directly related to health, and then there are a couple of them that indirectly relate to health. For example, if you look at the eradicating extreme poverty and hunger, we know that there's a relationship between health and well-being and the economic development in a particular environment. Education, very much linked to health. So we see a lot of linkages either directly or indirectly to health. So this still remains a big challenge for us, both in the United States and worldwide. Money solves some problems, at least at the individual level. So this graph just shows us the disparities in terms of health and well-being and how it relates to the income of people. And as you might expect, as income goes up, so does the health condition, which is a sad reality for us that we still have these disparities in this day and age, and they are pretty severe. But money doesn't solve all problems, especially if you look at it at the nation level, we spend a lot of money on healthcare. Yet, we look at the outcomes and it doesn't show up in the outcomes. So we are still behind compared to other nations in terms of the health outcomes in this country, even though we are spending a lot more than some of the other developed nations. So that's another, that again remains another big challenge for us in the health system space. So this is just a picture that shows some of the complexities in health systems. We have a lot of fragmentation. We have issues in prevention, preventive services, actually keeping people healthy versus dealing with the complications after they emerge. And we also have issues once treatment is completed, following up and making sure that we maintain health and well-being. So all of these remain a significant issue still in this country, despite all the progress that we have made. So part of the reason is that it's complex. So we might look at this and say, wow, this looks very complicated. But as many of you in the room know, health systems are a lot more complex than these Ruby Goldberg kind of systems that we see. We have multiple stakeholders who play a role. Their incentives are sometimes not aligned. They have their own objectives, and they are not always on the same page in terms of their objectives. We have different physical spaces where healthcare is delivered or preventive services take place, including our schools, workplaces, our communities. So it's really not just limited to clinics and hospitals. It expands way beyond those physical spaces. We sometimes have limitations on information in terms of what people have, what we can communicate to them, how much of the information they retain. So this also complicates things. And then, of course, we always have some sort of uncertainty, either at the individual level or at the community level or at the system level. So when we think about this entire system, we see the complexity. And it's not just the physical well-being, but we also have the mental health and well-being. And those are obviously very much linked to each other and impact each other both ways. So that further adds to the complexity that we have. So there are many, many government organizations. You can pull up quotes from a lot of different places in terms of some of these challenges, complexity, and highlighting the need for joining our forces from different units, different organizations, rather than working in silos to make a difference. So I just pulled one quote here. This is from a CDC report, but you can easily find other quotes pointing out the same observations. So what we are going to do today is to discuss some topics that relate to transforming health systems. Particularly, we want to think about ways we can change health systems from sick care to healthcare. So even though we call it healthcare, as many of you know, a lot of our activities in health system space focus on sick care. Somebody gets sick, and then they seek treatment, we treat them, and so on and so forth. So there is, of course, effort spent on the other side as well, on prevention, but can we actually grow that more so that we can do more healthcare and less sick care moving forward? So that's going to be some of our focus areas today. So we hope that the event facilitates dialogue across organizations, sectors, because we have a lot of different organizations represented here, a lot of sectors represented here, from public health to hospitals and clinics to education and so on. So hopefully there's going to be some cross-pollination of ideas and maybe some new collaborations. So we hope to identify some emerging topics as well as ongoing challenges, which might motivate new research here at Georgia Tech. We are on Georgia Tech campus, but we also have several of our friends from other universities in Atlanta joining us today. So we hope that some new research ideas and collaborations might start thanks to this event. And then we also would like to get ideas about how we can improve our education of tomorrow's leaders and the next generation in health systems. We also have several students in the audience who are joining us today, and hopefully what they hear is going to be inspirational to them, both in terms of their education as well as their future careers. So one nice thing about Georgia Tech is that our students get a lot of hands-on experiences while they are here through projects, co-ops, internships, as well as some of the other things that they do in our classes. So they have a lot of opportunities for learning and implementing what they learn in different areas, health systems being one of them. So hopefully this event will also serve as inspiration for education as well. So one area that the Center for Health and Humanitarian Systems emphasizes is systems, as the name implies, and systems engineering in particular. The principles from systems engineering, as well as the overall concept of systems thinking, has been successfully implemented in a variety of industries over the years, manufacturing, airlines, finance, and so on and so forth. And we have seen an increasing use of health systems engineering in health systems as well. So we are very, very happy that the collaborations are increasing, but there is definitely more room to grow there and potential for bigger impact of systems engineering in the healthcare area. So this really could expand from individual applications, implementations, as well as education and training. Again, the idea is to not look at the individual pieces of the system and only focus on those, but really expand our thinking to the system as a whole, so that we can actually see if we take a particular action here, what's the impact not only in this limited area, but more broadly within the system across the different units. So going back to our complex health systems picture, we hope that systems engineering can actually make a difference. And it utilizes a lot of different tools and methodologies that I'm sure you all have heard in your work or education. So for example, we use predictive analytics, descriptive analytics that looks at historically how have we done in the system, what are some of the trends. So basically understanding how we came to where we are and what our current status is. So quantifying and understanding where we are. We use predictive analytics by utilizing machine learning or other kinds of techniques to see where things might be going from here. Particularly if we take certain actions, we want to understand what the future might look like. And then we also use prescriptive analytics, which utilizes tools such as optimization, simulation, and others, basically trying to find out the best combination of actions, the best allocation of limited resources, so that we can achieve certain goals considering constraints or other priorities within our system. So those are some of the things that are utilized within the systems engineering framework. So because I'm a professor, I like to give homework. So here is your homework for today. So as you sit in the room and listen to these various presentations and discussions, and also as you engage with our poster presenters during the break, please think about what kind of knowledge you can take for yourself, for your colleagues, your organization, and also for the constituents that your organization serves. So please keep thinking about this and take some notes. Think about what action you can take as an individual or in your professional role, and what action can you actually motivate others to take? So you can be a change agent. We all can make a difference. So please think about these and share your thoughts with your network and your colleagues, and hopefully it leads to some positive change. So I would like to also acknowledge our friends, organizations who contributed to this event by sponsoring the School of Industrial and Systems Engineering and the Institute for People and Technology have been the co-sponsors for this event, so we are grateful to them for their ongoing support. And again, I invite all of you to visit our center's website, and please contact me or any of our colleagues within the center, affiliated with the center, if you have any ideas, questions, and so on.